Beekeeping is an exciting endeavor, and frankly, what's not to like? You get honey, you pollinate crops, you help bees. Bees are biologically fascinating. All of that is great, but beekeeping, for some, can be accompanied by a little bit of apprehension. After all, what do we learn about bees from the very beginning of our lives? That they can sting, that we need to be careful, we need to watch out for bees. We think the same about wasps and all of these other stinging insects. All of these things are things that we've been trying to worry about. And throw in the fact that bees have that natural aposematic or warning coloration, right? Yellow, black, all of these are danger signs. And we just get overwhelmed sometimes, especially as new beekeepers, about fear and apprehension associated with bees. So how can we get comfortable working bees? How can we get comfortable around bees? Well, I like to start by knowing as much about the subject as possible. I happen to be a terrible flyer. I'm quite apprehensive about flying, and one of the things that I've learned about flying is the more that you know what those sounds are, what the plane movements are, etc., the more that you can overcome the fear associated with that. I know, well, bees, beekeeping, it's very similar. Just general knowledge increase really helps that fear and apprehension. Read as much as you can. Watch as many videos as you can. Talk with other beekeepers. Go to beekeeper meetings. Submerge yourself in bee culture. Knowledge is power, and learning as much as you can about bees, why they're doing what they're doing, what their flight behavior means, all of these things can help calm your apprehension as you learn what to expect while you're around them. So I graduate from learning as much as I can about bees to introducing myself to bees. And one of the best ways to do that is just first through an observation hive. See bees on the other side of a sheet of glass where they can't sting you, where they can't come after you. See what they're doing, learn their behavior, know how they're responding, anticipate what they're going to do next when this happens, and you can get yourself calm around bees. The next step is the step towards the hive. The good news in beekeeping is there's all of this personal protective equipment associated with working bees, right? Veils that protect your head and neck, gloves that protect your hands and forearms, suits that protect the rest of your body, boots that protect your feet. So if you're apprehensive about bees, put on the full bee suit. There's no shame at all in wearing a veil and gloves and a suit and boots and being ready for that first time that you enter a colony, the first year that you work with a colony. And if you're apprehensive, don't go alone. With your full bee suit, work bees with other beekeepers. See what their movements cause the bees to do. See how they respond when bees are coming up off of the combs or they're starting to hit your veil. Learning how other beekeepers handle bees is a really good way to anticipate what the bees are going to do when you do those same things, and then also knowing how to respond when the bees do it. And what you'll find is you'll find yourself slowly getting closer and closer and closer to the bees, and over the weeks and the months and the years, you'll find yourself changing your personal protective equipment from the full bee suit and gloves to maybe with the jacket and gloves to maybe just the jacket. And before long, you'll be working bees in short sleeves and a bee veil. Even if putting on a full bee suit with a veil and gloves is what's necessary to keep that apprehension at bay, feel comfortable doing it. In the honeybee world, you don't have to do anything you're not comfortable doing, so ease into it. Learn as much as you can, see bees in observation hives, work with beekeepers, and then go out on your own. And know that you always have people around you available to serve as a resource and a sounding board to help cool your apprehension to make beekeeping more enjoyable for you.